This is the Lewis structure for ethanoic acid or acetic acid. First thing you have to do is balance electrons. Carbon has four, three hydrogens each with one. Carbon has four, two oxygens each with six, and one last hydrogen. So we add it up, we have 7, 11, and 12, that's 23, 24 balanced electrons. So the hydrogen belongs to the previous carbon, so we have CH3 right there, connected to a carbon, and this has one oxygen and one OH. All right, so let's count our bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bonds times 2 is 14 electrons. We'll start with this oxygen, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. All right, so this carbon right here is deficient in its octet, so what we're going to do is we're going to take a lone pair off of this oxygen and make a double bond. And there's your acetic acid Lewis dot structure. Now, if you need hybridization, we'll look at how many electron regions we have. 1, 2, 3, 4 surrounding the carbon. So that's sp3, one letter for each region. This carbon right here has 1, 2, 3 electron regions. That's sp2. This oxygen right here, this has 1, 2, 3, 4 electron regions. That's sp3 hybridized. And this oxygen has 1, 2, 3 regions. So that's sp2 hybridized. If you need to know bond angles, well, sp3 gives you, if there's no lone pairs, a tetrahedral shape, which is 109.5 degrees. This sp2 hybridization, since they're all atoms, gives you a trigonal planar shape, which is 120 degree bond angle. This oxygen right here gives you sp3, but there's two lone pairs, so it gives you a bent shape, which is 109.5 minus 5 degrees for each lone pair, so 104.5. And this right here is linear. If you need to know your sigma and pi bonds, well, sigma are all your single bonds, so you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 single, but a double bond also has one, so that's 7 single bonds, or sigma bonds. Pi bonds are the additional bonds on top of the sigma. A double bond has one sigma and one pi, and there's your Lewis dot structure for acetic acid or ethanoic acid.